everyone. I have a deck of cards workout for you today. Deck of cards workouts are tough and they're usually on the longer side. They are not something I would recommend doing all the time. They can be pretty arduous, but I get requests from all the time. So once in a while, they're fun. They're a good challenge. I'm happy to put one together twice a year. So today we're gonna keep it all low impact. There's no jumping. For equipment, we're gonna use a set of heavy-ish weights. I'm using a set of 15s, and then we're going to incorporate sliders as well. We're gonna have one foot on each for a couple of the moves, so I would have two. If you're on hardwood floor, dish towels work. If you're on carpet, paper plates work. If you're using a dish towel, you don't necessarily need to. You could just have it folded the long way so that you can fit both feet on it, up to you. Here are how deck of cards workouts go if this is your first one. So each suit in an actual deck of cards, I have one right here, corresponds to a different exercise. And the number on the card tells you how many reps to do. Face cards are 10 reps. Aces are just one rep. Sometimes I've done classes where aces are 11 reps. It makes the workout too long. Okay, so aces are one rep today, face cards 10. And we just go through the deck. Now I'm gonna flip over four cards at a time, just so there's not so much back and forth. So I'll flip over four, we'll complete all the reps of whatever exercises show up, and then you get to recover while I go back to the deck and flip over the next four. That's kind of your rest time. Now your pace may be different than mine. If you're going quicker than I am, you could either fast forward the video as needed, or you could just use that as an extended recovery time while I finish up my reps. If you're going a little slower than I am, again, you can pause the video as needed, or you can just commit to completing however many reps you get to in the time it takes me to complete mine. So there are a couple different ways to approach this. Now, because these workouts are tough and long, you can always stop at the halfway point. So when we do get halfway through the deck, I'll give you a heads up in case you want to call it for your workout for the day at that point. We will start class with a guided warm-up focused on mobility, some dynamic movement to bring the heart rate up a little bit, and we'll finish up with a guided cool down. For our warm-up, let's actually start down on the mat in a tabletop position, and then we'll gradually make our way to standing. And a note, you'll notice I have my mat this way so that I have space for sliding. So let's come into a tabletop position. I'm gonna have my knees on the mat, hands just on the floor, and we'll start with a cat-cow. So as you inhale, gaze shifts up, tailbone reaches up to the ceiling, and as you exhale, you press the floor away, round your spine up towards the ceiling. Inhale, spinal extension. Exhale, spinal flexion. Move with your breath on this one. Let's do one more. And then I want you to elongate the spine through neutral. And from here, I want you to tuck your toes under. So we're going to inhale to prepare. And then as we exhale, I want you to feel that 360 brace through the core. And I just want you to lift your knees up to a 2-inch hover. Stay for an inhale. Stay for an exhale. And then lower the knees down to the mat as you inhale. Let's do that again. On the exhale, brace through the core, lift the knees to a hover and stay for a breath. So I just want us to fire up through the deep stabilizing core layers with this. Lower the knees down. Just one more time. Hold in the bear plank. And then knees come down. Let's come into a fluid. Thread the needle. You can untuck the toes. So you're going to lift your left elbow up to the ceiling. And you're going to thread it through the right, bending the right elbow, cheek to the mat. So we have an open twist, exhale, close twist. So we're mobilizing through the mid spine here. Let's do one more. And then bring it through center and let's take it over to the other side. Right elbow up to the ceiling, open twist, thread it through, close the twist. Give me one more. And then I want you to come through center. I want you to send your bum back over the heels and sweep the arms back. So we're in this hinged position. And as you come upright, the arms sweep overhead. So we have an arm sweep with a hip hinge, firing through the glutes as you come upright, maintaining a long, neutral spine. We're gonna hold the hip hinge for arm circles in 3, 2, hold the hip hinge and we just trace circles with the arms from there. Big circles, but not so big that you flare open to the front of your rib cage. Switch direction of your circles. Hands are going to come down to the mat, tabletop position. We'll tuck our toes under again. We'll move from a bear plank to a down dog. Let's go. Hands come down to the floor. You tuck your toes under. We lift our hips up towards down dog, pressing the heels towards the floor, and then bend the knees to a bear plank hover. We lift up and close. So opening up through the backs of the legs here. The backs of our legs are going to get a lot of love today, the hamstrings, the glutes. Next time you go up into that down dog, I want you to hold. We're going to separate your feet just a smidge wider than hips distance. We're going to do an inchworm to world's greatest. So I want you to walk your hands in towards your feet. And then I want you to walk them all the way out to this plank. Step one foot outside the hand. Twist it open. And then just take it over to the other side. And when you're back in your plank, we pike the hips up, keeping the legs straight if possible. Walk it in. Walk it out. World's greatest, once either side. Let's do this combo one more time. We inchworm it in. We inchworm it out. World's greatest, once either side. And this time when we inchworm it into our forward fold, I want you to pause again. Make sure feet are a little wider than hips. And just move between this forward fold into a low wide squat. We drop the hips down, lift the chest, straighten the leg, hands to the mat. So we're going to come into our dynamic movement section up next. I'm going to give you three moves. We'll go through them twice. The third move, we are going to use one weight just to kind of ease us into our weighted work. Next time you come into your forward fold, pause here, and then vertebrae by vertebrae, roll it up to stand. All right, so we got squat to hip circle up first. So we're going to squat. Cross midline, step it wide, just taking it side to side. We'll get some lateral movement, and up next, it'll be a side lunge slide with a little reach and twist. Last hip circle, step those feet wide, side lunge to one side, opposite hand towards that foot, take it across. So up next, we're gonna grab one weight, we'll hold it at our chest, and it'll just be a hip hinge to a squat. In 3, 2, 1. Grab one weight, hold it at your chest. I'm just gonna hold it a little apart so I don't muffle my mic. And from here, it's a hinge, slide the hips back. Then a squat, bend the knees. And then you press your feet into the floor, come up to stand. So just establishing that connection to our mid-back. Stay open through the chest as you do this. One more. Stand it up, put that weight down, squat to hip circle, going through those one more time. So after this, I'll give you a preview of our four exercises today, and then we will get to the fun stuff. Fun in quotations. Side lunge slide in 2 and 1. Nice wide stance. Slide it across, adding that little twist. You're going to grab your weight to finish, hinge to squat, in 3, 2, 1. Stand it up, grab your weight, hold it at your chest. Let's go. You hinge it, drop to a squat, and stand. Final one. Press to stand, and here's your exercise preview. So I want you to really pay attention to this preview because I'm gonna show you the modifications now because it's gonna be too tough to show them during the class since we change the exercise so frequently, okay? So first exercise, hearts. It's a sliding plank to pike, sliding knee tuck. That combo, hips up and down, knees in and out, is one rep. To modify, ditch the gliders. In a plank position, you step to bear plank, step to full plank, slide the hips up like a pike and back down. Step, hips slide up and back and down. Diamonds, we're gonna have both weights. It's gonna be 2 skier swings. On the second one, you rack those weights to your shoulders. You drop down to a squat. Skier swings, just like a kettlebell swing, except you have one weight in either hand going to the outside of your hips. Now, if you're uncomfortable swinging, then the modification I want you to do is similar to what we did in the warm-up. You hold the weight at your chest, two hinges, drop to squat, two hinges, drop to squat. So spades, we do the rep number on the right and then the rep number on the left. In a low lunge position with the back lunge on our glider, it's a sliding lunge pulse, and then a knee slide as we do a single arm row. Sliding lunge pulse, single arm row. To modify that, ditch the slider, okay? Starting upright, you're gonna step to a back lunge, row, come all the way upright. Step to a back lunge, row, all the way upright. And finally, clubs. We are in a hip bridge position with our feet on the gliders. It's gonna be a chest press, lowering the elbows all the way to the floor for support, heel slide out and in. Real tough one for the hamstrings. Chest press, anchor the elbows down, slide the heels out and in. To modify, again, ditch the gliders. You're gonna be in a hip bridge position. It's one chest press and then one hip pulse down and up. Chest press, hip pulse down and up. Okay, so it's gonna be a tough one. We got it. We're gonna flip over all those cards eventually. Let's go. All right, let's see what our first four are. So we have 10 skier swings, 7 of the lunges, 7 of the chest press heel slides, ooh, and then another 10 of the lunges. So we can just put those together to consolidate. All right, so that's 10 skier swings to a squat, 17 of the lunges, the sliding lunge, and then 7 of the chest press heel slide. Let's get to it. And again, you're going at your own pace. Don't worry if it is faster or slower than mine. So 2 skier swings, drop to a squat, that counts as 1 rep. We're doing 10. Start by sending your hips back, modification, hip hinge, squat. Okay, let's go. On the second one, rack the weight, drop to a squat, that's 1. I'm not gonna count because I don't wanna throw off your count because you could be going faster or slower than me, which is fine. This is the last rep for me. Woo, okay. So now 17 lunge pulse, single arm row. So I'm gonna grab one of my sliders. Whatever foot is on the glider, that is the hand that has the weight. Other foot is forward, we find our low lunge, it's a pulse, and then a knee slide with a row. So square the hip, hinge forward as you come to your low lunge, pulse it up, and down, knee slide row, that's 1. If you lose count, just stop when I do. All right, so I just finished on that side. Same thing, other side for me. And you can always break it up. You don't have to do 17 straight. Maybe you do 10, 10, 7, 7. All right, done for me. So now moving on to the 7 chest press heel slides. So we come to that bridge position. Remember the chest press, let your elbows hit the floor at the bottom because they're gonna anchor you into place for that heel slide, okay? So we come down, feet are hips distance apart, lift those hips up into a bridge. So chest press up, anchor the elbows, slide the heels out, slide them in, that's one. I know this one is tough. Again, you can do a hip pulse instead of the heel slide. Woo, all right, that is seven for me. Okay, so first four cards complete. You use this as kind of your recovery while I flip over the next four. All right, we got seven of the sliding planks, five of the chest press heel slide, seven of the lunges, and another six of the chest press heel slide. So we can put those together. So I'm going to do, since I'm already down on the mat, I'm going to do the planks and then the chest press, and then I'll come to standing for the lunges so we can kind of rearrange, okay? So for the sliding planks, your feet are on the gliders. You do not need the weights. It's a pike and a knee tuck. That counts as one rep. We're doing seven. So we spread out through the fingers, hands under shoulders, feet on the gliders. Let's go. Up, down, in, out. That's one. All right, that's seven for me. So now we have 11 chest press heel slides. So another way to modify, you don't have to do both legs sliding out at once. Maybe you just slide one leg out and in while the other foot stays planted. I might switch to that after I do a few reps because this one is so hard. All right, hips up into your bridge position. Press, anchor the elbows, slide. That's one. If you're doing single leg, it looks like that. And then you just alternate the next rep. Don't flare open through the ribs. Keep reaching your tailbone to your knees. That's 11 for me. All right, I'm gonna come to standing. You'll notice I mixed in some of the easier ones where I just do one leg out and in. Okay, so seven reps of the lunge pulse with that knee slide row. Whatever foot is on the glider, that's the foot that has the row to start. Find your low lunge, hinge forward. Pulse the legs, row and knee slide. That's seven on that side. Switch into the other leg. Okay, done for me. So now this is your recovery time. While I flip over the next four. Okay, we got 5 of the lunges, 9 of the planks, 6 of the skier swings, 8 of the chest press heel slides. So all 4 exercises here, we'll start with 5 of those lunges that we were just doing. 5 each side, you know the deal. Let's go. Once you've done 5 on that side, switch to the other. Okay, so now we have those planks. Actually, I'm just gonna switch the order. I'm gonna do the skier swing since I'm already standing. So we're gonna grab both weights. If you're doing the modification, just one. And it's going to be 6 of those, okay? Swing, swing, squat. Start by sliding the hips back. Right, that is 6 for me. Now I'm going to come down to the mat. So I'm going to start with those planks, and we're doing 9 of those. Up and down with the hips, in and out with the knees is 1 rep. Spread out through those hands, hands under shoulders. Again, you can ditch the gliders and step, 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 and hip slide instead. Okay, that's 9 for me. 8 chest press heel slides. Hardest, both heels slide out and in together. When needed, just slide 1 heel out, keep the other foot planted, okay? I'll be doing a mix through the workout. Because if form starts to slip and get sloppy, you're better off just doing 1 at a time, okay? Lift those hips up. Chest press, heel slide. Squeeze the glutes, squeeze the glutes, push those hips up. If you do just 1 leg, hips still lower, and you press them up to that bridge, okay? Woo! All right, that's 8 for me. Okay, done with those 4. We'll flip over the next. We're just about almost 25% through the deck. All right, so the next 4, we have 1 skier swing. That's nice. We have 10 of the chest press heel slide. Those are so hard. Another 10 of them. That makes 20. Woof. We can break it up though. And then 3 of the lunges. Okay, so let's get the quickies out of the way and then we will come down to the mat and tackle our 20 chest press heel slides. Okay, so 1 skier swing to the squat, nice enough. Swing, swing rack the weight, drop to your squat, stand. 1 weight goes down. Now let's do our 3 of the lunges on either side. Find that low lunge position, brace to the core, pulse it up and down, knee slide in row. And we switch sides. Okay. Okay, now the tough one. So we have 20 reps of that chest press heel slide. So you can take breaks as needed. Maybe you do 10, rest, do another 10. Or since we are doing such a long amount, maybe you alternate chest press right side slides, chest press left side slides. I'm probably going to alternate between both together, and then I'll mix in some single leg ones and just chip away at those 20 reps, okay? So start in your hip bridge, fire through the glutes, okay? You're not sinking into your lower back, really gotta squeeze the bum. Chest press, anchor the elbows down for support so you can slide out as the heels slide in, push those hips up. I'm halfway there, mixing in some of the alternating. I've been doing both legs, and then a rep just the right, rep just the left, and that is working for me. I'm on my last one. I'm gonna do double leg. Oh, 20. Woo! That is tough. All right. I will flip over the next four. We got one of the chest press heel slide. We can do one. 8 of the lunges. 4 of the skier swings. And then another 2 of the chest press heel slides, making it 3 total. Since we're already down here, I'm just gonna crank out 3 more of the reps here. If you don't like the option sliding one leg out at a time, you could also not use the gliders, and again, it'd be chest press, and then you just lower and lift the hips back up into that bridge, okay? So lots of options with this one because I do know it's a doozy. Our hamstrings are gonna be talking to us tomorrow for sure. 3 reps, so I'm gonna do all 3, both legs together. Reach the tailbone to the knees so that you're neutral through the pelvis. Chest press. So when you do that heel slide back in, the goal is to lift the hips up at the same time the heel slides in. You don't want to first slide the heels in, then push the hips up. That's 3. All right, now we'll come to stand. 8 of the lunges either side. I like the lunges. These for me, these are like, okay, a nice one. Stay open through the chest when you do that row. That's 8 for me on that side. Okay, and now we have 4 of the skier swings to squats. open through the chest. It's a hip hinge, two of those, then the squat. So hip slide, back, drive through the glutes as they come forward. And four. All right, I feel like we've gotten a couple good rounds. I feel like we're gonna be doomed for some high numbers in this next flip around. Fingers crossed. Let's see. We have four of the lunges, nine of the chest press heel slides. I feel like we're getting all the heel slides out of the way, which is probably a good thing. 10 more of the lunges, so that's 14. And then nine of the skier swings to squat. All right, I'm going to, since I'm kneeling down on the ground already, I'm gonna start with the chest press heel slides, then come to standing for the rest. All right, we got nine of these. Oh, Pickles is joining the party. Hi, honey, you gotta get out of my way, babe. Oh, you get a longer break. Move, honey, move. You can jump up on your own. Okay, let's do it. Nine of these. Alternate if needed, or take out the slider if needed and just pulse the hips. I like my mixing both together, one right, one left. Oh, that was ugly. Whew. All right, that's nine for me. Gonna come to standing now. And I'm going to do 14 of the lunges on either side. If you wanna break it up and do 7-7-7-7, absolutely can do that. I'll see how I feel. Goal is to do 14 straight though. I think I got it. When you row, elbow goes back and up. That's 14 on that side for me. All right, done with those. So now we have nine reps of the swing squat. Gonna be tough. Take your time with it. You can always hinge squat instead of swing. Take breaks as needed. Do not need to go at the same pace as me. Could go slower, could also mean you go faster. Last one for me. Nine. Okay. So we are almost at the halfway point. So instead of flipping over four, I'm only going to flip over two so that if you want to stop your workout at the halfway point, you can. All right. So just going to flip over two, but of course it's a 10, 10 of the skier swings. Oh my God. And 10 of the sliding plank knee tucks. I'm going to do the plank first because we just did all of those skier swings and then I'll come to stand. So we got 10 of the pike knee tucks. Whew. All right. We're at the halfway point after these two. Okay. Let's get through it. And then we'll take a longer recovery, whether you're stopping or continuing. We'll break. Okay. 10 reps. You got this. Legs are together. I lost count, so I'm just going to do one more, but that might have been 11. Okay, I'm done. Maybe two done. Okay. 10 reps of the skier swings, and then we get a long break, or maybe you choose to be done for today and you do the second half another day. All right, we got this. Take your time. Swing, swing, squat. That's halfway for me. Last one. All right, we are halfway through the deck, so we'll take a longer recovery. If you are good, you can skip ahead to the cool down. I have times listed in the video description. And if you click on the time in front of cool down, it'll jump you right to that. So if you're done, go there. If you're gonna power through the second half with me, grab a drink of water, which I'm gonna do in a second, catch your breath, then we start back at it. You still have time to recover, no rush. I'll fix my hair and then I'll flip over our next four. I feel like we have a lot of planks coming our way. Feels like we should be through a lot of the lunges, but it always feels that way with deck of cards workouts. Just when you think like, oh, we must be almost done with this exercise, another 10 will pop up. All right, so let's see what we have coming up next. 10 of the chest press heel slides. Oh yay, my favorite. 10 of the lunges. Oh my gosh. 10 of the planks. 5 of the skier swings. So we have all four exercises. 10, 10, 10, 5. Okay, so how am I going to arrange them? I'm going to do the stuff down on the mat first. So I'm going to do the chest press heel slides, get those out of the way. Then I'm going to do the sliding planks. And then I'm going to come up to standing and I'll do the lunges and then finish with the skier swings. Okay, that's the game plan. Chest press, heel slides. You have options with these. I like my both together, then one, then the other. Do what works for you though. All right, now, and when you do the chest press, make sure your elbows aren't all the way up hiked to your ears. Okay, they're a little lower than the shoulders actually. All right, let's do it, 10. Ooh, did the three doubles in a row go me? Last one for me. Oh, those are tough. Okay, 10 of the planks. Oops, what am I doing? Pike, knee slide. All right, that's 10 for me. Gonna come up and do the 10 lunges, 10 reps each side. Just need one weight. Just ball the foot on the glider. Keep that heel lifted. If 10 straight is too much, do 5-5-5-5 alternating. That's 10 on that side. Okay, that's it for those for me. Now, 5 reps of the skier swings, both weights, or just one if you're doing the modified hinge squat. Okay. Okay, and that was 5. All right, time to flip over the next 4. Let's see what we got. 5 of the planks, 10 of the skier swings, eek! Another 10 of the planks, so it's 15. And then 2 of the lunges. Okay, so I'm gonna do the planks first. I'm gonna do 15 straight. You can break up these reps however you want. You can go between exercises. You don't have to do what I'm doing. Okay, so do what's best for you. You have the numbers of each on the screen, so you know what to get through, all right? I'm gonna do 15 of those planks to start. Pike in a knee tuck equals 1 rep. Pause as needed. Thank you. 15 for me. All right, now 10 of the skier swings. I'm just relieved we don't have any of the heel slides. Chest presses this round. Okay, both weights. This is the part of the class where I start slowing down. Open through the chest, neutral spine, brace through the core. Start by swinging hips back, drive through the hips. That's halfway for me. Last one. All right, two of the lunges. That's nice. Two, what a beautiful number. Two reps each side. Oh, what a joy this is. And done. Woo! All right. So you get that little recovery while I flip over our next batch. Okay, let's see. We got two of the planks. Love a two. Eight of the skier swings. Three of the chest press heel slides. And another 10 of the chest press heel slides. So that's 13. I'm going to get the chest press heel slides out of the way first. I'm going to do those. Then I'm going to do the two planks, and then I'll come up to stand for the skier swings. Break it up how you want. Okay. Need both weights. Need both gliders. 13 reps. You don't have to do 13 straight if you want to break it up. Let's do it. Really focus on pushing the hips up, firing through the glutes. I'm on my last one. I'm going to do both heels together. All right. Woo. So now I'm going to go into those planks. Just two. So nice. That was lovely. And now we have eight of the skier swings. Whew. All right, these are getting old. These are starting to reach heel slide status for me. Let's do it, eight. done. Woo, okay. Gonna flip over the next four. Oh, we're getting there. I think we have like 14 cards to get through if my math is correct, which it could very well be wrong. We got 8 of the planks, 10 of the skier swings, 6 of the lunges, and then another 1 of the lunge. So that's 7 of the lunges. Okay, so I'm gonna break this up. I'm gonna do the planks first, then I'm gonna do the lunges, then I'm gonna do the skier swings. All right, we got this. Once we're through with these four, we're over 75% of the way through the deck, okay? There's a light at the end of the tunnel. 8 reps, let's go. Okay, that's 8 for me. Now 7 of the lunges, 7 each side. Seven that side. I don't talk a lot during these deck of cards classes because I don't want to throw off your count. So these are great classes to like get some music going. Okay, done with those. 10 of the skier swings. Oh boy. All right. Let's see what the next four are. We're getting there. 3 of the planks. Love a 3. 3 of the skier swings. 4 of the chest press heel slides. And then another 6 of the planks. Wow, this is not a bad round. So that's 9 of the planks. I'm going to do 9 of the planks, then I'm going to do 4 of the chest press heel slides, and then I'll come to standing for the 3 skier swings. All right, I'm feeling good. All in all, honestly, this has been a pretty balanced deck. Sometimes I do these classes, and it's like you get all the 10 reppers right in a row, and it's brutal. This has been like tough, but a manageable deck of cards class. Maybe I should like shuffle the cards to be like this every time I do these. Okay. 9 of the planks. All right, that's 9 of those. Now 4 of the chest press. Pickles is like, are you almost done? It is time for my walk. Meanwhile, Squeaky is out cold. He was going crazy at the dog park today, so he's tired. 4 reps. Don't let your ribs flare open on these, okay? Or else all the pressure is going to go into your lower back. You got to squeeze glutes and engage hamstrings. Oops, that was 4.5. Okay, and now the 3 skier swings. I'm like all of a sudden talkative because I'm so happy to get all these low numbers this round. All right, let's see what's on deck next. I think we're in single digits, guys. I think we are. We're in single digits. We got this. Just power through. Oh, there's a 10. 10 of the planks, plus another 1 of the planks, so 11. I don't mind the planks. I know everyone has their challenges. Planks, I don't mind. 2 of the skier swings, 9 of the lunges. Oh, that's 4. Okay. And then what? Oh, and then we only have 2 left. Oh, little finisher. Okay. So I'm going to do the 11 planks, then I'm going to do, and then I'll come to stand and I'll do the lunges and then the skier swings. Okay. All right, let's do it. 11 planks. Break it up if you need to. You don't have to do 11 straight. That's 11. Now I'm going to do 9 of the lunges each side. Oh man, we're so close. We're so close. Don't get sloppy with the form though. I know it's exciting when we're almost done. Don't round your shoulders. All right, that's 9 that side. That's 9. All right, 2 skier swings. All right, let's see what those last 2 hold for us. This is your little finisher and then we cool it down. All right, 10, but of the lunges, that's not bad. And then 4 of the planks. All right, I'm gonna do the lunges first, and then we can finish body weight and we'll cool it down on the mat, okay? So I'm gonna do 10, ooh, only need 1. 10 reps of the lunge each side, or if 10 straight is too much, do 5-5, 5-5, alternating. Home stretch. I'm like on a mission. Get these done, get these done. Ten that side. All 10, done with the weights. 4 reps of the planks, and then we cool it down. Let's do it. Find that plank position. Last rep. And from here, drop your knees down. Knees can come wide. I'm just gonna flip around so my knees are on the mat. And just find a child's pose for a second. Oh boy. Deck of cards classes are a doozy. Again, like I said at the start of class, great for a once in a while challenge. Don't do workouts this long and this hard all the time though, okay? Highly unnecessary. All right, let's come forward into a kneeling lunge position. So I'm just gonna step my right foot forward, square the hips, squeeze into the glutes, and I'm gonna press those hips forward for hip flexor stretch. Let's take our back left arm and reach it up and then side bend over to the right. Coming up through center, shift your hips back, straightening out your front right leg, and then half split, you're gonna fold forward. Might feel good to wrap your hands around the foot and gently pull it back towards you, or maybe just tent fingertips on the floor. Whatever works for you. Really kind of marinate in this stretch because we did a lot for the backs of the legs today. If you don't feel the stretch to the back of your leg, you might need to bring your hips instead of like tucking under, really think of hinging and sliding them back. Let's take it over to the other side. Left foot forward, right knee down. Square the hips, squeeze the glutes, and then press the pelvis forward. Hip flexor stretch. Let's reach that right arm up and side bend over to the left. Oh, that feels good. Coming upright, send those hips back, square the hips. And again, instead of rounding forward and tucking your tailbone under, think hinge, slide the hips back as you bring your chest towards your knee. And that's gonna help you feel the hamstrings more. And you also need to really square the hips. So pull that back hip forward a little bit. So if you like this class, I have a couple more deck of cards classes on my channel. One of them is really long, it's 90 minutes, and you gotta break that one in half. The others are more like, I think around 45, 50 minutes. All right, and then let's come to a kneeling position. To finish, I want you to interlace, or I should face the side, as you can see. Interlace your fingers behind your back and start by just pressing the knuckles away from you, opening up through the chest, but close your rib cage. And then from here, I'm just hitting my couch, so I'm gonna come up. And then from here, just lift your arms up a little bit for a nice stretch through the chest and shoulders. Releasing those hands, let's finish with one breath together. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, release. Awesome work today. We did it. We'll see you next time.